Hello everyone, this is Lewis Natrans, aka 8L25, aka Lewis JM. I'm here at the BowlMor Lanes in Chelsea Piers, New York City. And I'm with my Hankering Court group, which is down there, which they're wrapping up. Today I'm going to show you like two floors of arcade goodness, upstairs and downstairs. You'll know more once you see. And we're going to see how the games are like and see if this is good or not. So, why don't we get started? So as you can see, this is a pretty good collection. Of course, this is like the second floor. It doesn't look like much now, but when you come downstairs, you see what they got. So why don't we begin? First off, there's the 20-year reunion of Ms. Pac-Man and Galaga, which has an arcade cabinet program here that shows like a lot of good arcade games. Kind of cool. Well, at least it's more variety than the others. Then we got Sega's Virtual Tennis 4, which has the four-player mode here. I mean, it's kind of... I never seen much of a virtual tennis around here since Dave & Buster's in the Dolphin Mall of Miami. I'm surprised they even still have these virtual tennis things. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I think it's alright. I think it's all wasters here. And then we have this Boost Hockey. Pretty nice so far. Then we got the Big Buck HD Wild, which is pretty much a hunting game. You see plenty of these all over the place, so yeah. Not my idea for fun, but at least they have one has a zombie mode, so that's a pretty cool thing. Then we got this little skee-ball thing, which looks pretty classic. Ski shooter, actually. We move down to the Foos Hockey. Sorry, the it's a little touch. There we go. Foos Soccer, actually. With all the little spinners here. And over here is the four-player co-op of Pac-Man. Next is the AC/DC pinball machine. Of course, you can't have pinball. You can't have an arcade without a pinball machine, even though there's just one of them here. And then over here is the toss or bounce Pong player. Kind of cool. Oh, and I almost forgot. They also have this air hockey board there. I didn't realize that till now. So yeah, it doesn't look like much upstairs, but of course this is a party room, so you won't see much of anything here. But let's go down downstairs because they have more arcade goodness, and see what they do. And of course I'm here with the Hankering for More, right, which is right over there. Hey guys, how you doing? So. Let's just take a look at the arcade in the back, which is right down there at the corner. It has a good collection. And over there they have like pools for people to play around in. So why don't we get started? So as you can see, it's pretty much busy, but it has a lot of good stuff around here and there. Of course, and right over there is the BowlMor Urban Mission, which is pretty much a laser tag, which is kind of cool. And I play laser tag once, it's kind of an interesting premise, but never get a chance to start using it. And over here we got the basketball hoops that have like Knicks and the Nets, which are called New York players. Of course, the Nets were once in New Jersey until they moved from the Izod Center to the Barclay, which kind of sucks. Whatever, at least we got the Devils from the other arena in New York. We got the Ice Ball Ski Ball. Another air hockey here, which is more glow in the dark. Then we got Sinkit from, which is more Pong. I think the other one was Sinkit too, I didn't read it, so yeah, I guess I should have known better. And over here we got Paintbrush Saga, which is a, which is based around those tablet games, which from what the news say are like big waste of time wasters. I never play those games myself. I'm more of a Angry Birds Transformers or a Temple Run, depending on what I'm doing. Anyways, it's a good game. Then we got the Barber Cut, which has like two games available for some reason. Could've been more. Then we got the Grab and Win, which has the wide varieties of either stuffed animals or big balls. Ice Factor, another crane game, which has more dolls, whether it be Garfield or Despicable Me, or it looks like more of those Star Wars things, I can't tell. Then we got the Blinking Crane Machine, which shows not much of a variety, I'm afraid, just the bracelets. And last but not least, we have Mario Kart Arcade DX. It's basically more of the Mario Kart arcade, but with more new characters. I think I saw, like, when I played it, there was like a Metal Mario and that Princess Stella from Mario Galaxy, along with that drum guy. I don't know who he is, but yeah, whatever the case, it's all pretty cool. It's nice to see that a game such as Mario Kart expanding from Nintendo to actual arcade games, and I think it's a pretty cool thing. So, why not? Big props. And that pretty much wraps up the arcades. Now, I gotta admit, this is a pretty nice place. Two floors worth of arcades back up and down. And, of course, well, I can't complete the tour without showing the bowling lanes, as you can see. So, yeah, pretty much it's a good chance if you have, like, friends, head on down to this BowlMor in, Chelsea, but there's also another BowlMor in Times Square you want to check out as well. And then there's like other places like Lucky Strike and of course Bowler City in Hackensack, which I have a couple of tours in. But whatever the case, whatever place you want to go, at least the bowling is pretty fun. So that's it with the tour. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Stay tuned for more videos, and I'll see you guys next time.